All right, it's actually getting late, but let's see how fast we can do this. I don't know if any of you have problem with ECOWAS, but I think all of us should have problem with ECOWAS. When ECOWAS is the economic body that embodies the various West African states with a motive of ensuring free movement among us, improvement in our economic activities, and then ensuring that we have better protection or better security through collaboration. And it happens to be that the regional body is failing in that mandate of ensuring that the region is stable. One, where countries don't respect their voices anymore, where their sanctions seem not to bite, where they seem not to be effective as we're expecting, then there's a real danger in West Africa. Now, you can set example with the coup that happened in Guinea, where Domboya was sanctioned, and yet Domboya did not heed to ECOWAS' call of restoring democracy. It equally happened in Mali. There were few sanctions, ultimatum was given. They did not. Mali also did the same thing. And then it is looking like ECOWAS sanctions seems not to be biting. The closure of border, financial sanctions, and then all that. It seems that these sanctions are not working. Maybe ECOWAS should take a deeper reflection with regards to the timing they approach countries when they are in coup. So you see, instead of ECOWAS dealing with the factors that result in the coup, including issues like unemployment, including issues like corruption, including issues like lack of development, we don't really do that. We don't really push ourselves so hard to solve some of these issues for the involving countries. And then ECOWAS comes in all of a sudden after the people have organized their coup, seeking to get a new direction or new partnership for themselves. And all of a sudden, ECOWAS comes in and then wants to dictate the direction for these countries. It then becomes very difficult. So I'm thinking that going forward, if truly ECOWAS wants to be effective, ECOWAS wants its membership states to heed to its call, not to sit and then at a point in time, if something happens, and then you just come up with some policy sanctions and then thinking that these countries should follow. Of course, the countries have been on their own without your help. And so what will your sanctions do to them? They will still find their way. Now you have Burkina Faso, Mali, Guinea, Niger. They will trade among themselves and your sanctions will be ineffective. I think it should be a worry for every well-meaning West African. Very, very important. All right. So that's my take on ECOWAS. Very sad. How we gonna do them? Yeah, man, then. Yeah, that's it. All right, this wouldn't take much of your time. Let me do it real quick. Now, you've realized that there is a coup at Niger, and then French is instructing ECOWAS to intervene and ensure that democracy is restored. Now, when you listen to the chairman of ECOWAS and the president of ECOWAS, ECOWAS is telling Niger to actually restore democracy. Other than that, there might be a military invasion. This is a serious issue. Now, when ECOWAS issued the threat, you also realize that some of the Francophone countries or the Francophone countries who have also experienced coup in recent times, the lives of Mali, Burkina Faso, are also giving their solidarity to the military junta in Niger, that if ECOWAS make such an attempt, they are also going to retaliate. Now, the power play that is happening here, I know many of you appreciate. We are talking about the West as against the East. Now, this is the dynamics. Many Francophone countries, or the Francophone countries which have experienced coup, are trying to push France away from their territories. Of course, France has become their colonial masters for a very long time. And then, per what is happening there, when you look at the factors that necessitated the various coups in the Francophone countries, they are trying to tell us that unemployment, corruption, nepotism and the likes are the basis for this coup, and then they are trying to ensure that they get maximum benefit out of the natural resources of their country. And as a result of that, the long-term relationship with France has not been beneficiary to them, and so they now want partners who will help them. And then you could clearly see that during protests in these countries, you could see flags of Russia also flying. And so there is a likelihood that after Mali. All right, so now I can say all eyes are watching. We all want to see what will happen finally. But then we also have to appreciate that Niger has been short-chained in terms of relationship between themselves and France. And then the almighty uranium resources that France depend on to light up the whole of France, talking about one third of their homes, that's huge. And then Niger actually deserves better. So let's see. I am very sure that Niger will definitely join the Russian mercenary group Wagner, or Wagner will be invited to protect Niger. And then when that happens, it means gradually President Putin is actually cementing himself, or cementing Russia's presence on the African continent. And then we see how best we can tap into it with regards to a partnership, and then how best we can get the best out of our agreement with other countries. So partnership that will benefit Africa, basically. Yeah.